Mrs. Merriam was in the hall crying, "Stop that! Stop that! Why is that funny?" "I think, Mrs. Merriam, you may be right in mistrusting Mr. "And you did?" Hannah Gruen asked. "We know she's Hannah Gruen. We have to keep saying Hannah Gruen." She hurried upstairs and unpacked the wig, upstairs. "How do you like all Debbie's hair?" "What? How do you all like Debbie's hair?" "Oh, they'll catch us," Bess wailed. "Oh, I'll never get those two ugly men that came out of that mansion." "What? I'll never forget." This time her groping hands found the rope on the rope. The rope. This time her groping hounds. To the girl's delight, the newcomer was Dick. That's not funny. "You're a real lifesaver, Dick," Bess exclaimed gratefully. "Come on, stop." "Surely," Bess remarked, "you don't expect to find a clue here."
"I do, Bess, and stop calling me Shirley. I'm Debbie Lynbrook."
Oh, God, that was dumb. "You girls will be surprised at what I'm going to ask Mr. Basswood. I'll meet you two at the nice soda shop over on that corner."
Corner.
"It's a beautiful day, isn't it?"
A wonderful day for the yacht race.
Ed learned there was to be a one-minute morning gun. Good morning, gun.
Warning gun.
"That guy behind us is putting up the spinnaker." "Spinnaker? Nancy, where's ours?"
"What's a spinnaker?"
"Look, Nancy, they're in trouble. I don't know what a spinnaker is. I have to keep saying spinnaker."
Surreptitiously. Oh, Nancy, why are you using big words? Surreptitiously.
"I must leave this sunny mum place."
"What?
Wait, Mr. Silver," she said. "Perhaps you would be interested in a sonata piece." "Oh!" cried Bess.
"Oh!" cried Bess.
"Oh!" cried Bess.
"Oh!"
"Heartily!"
I don't like yelling out sailor stuff.
"Heartily!"
I don't want to say it.
On display were statues of many sizes, made of various mysterious materials. "I can't afford an original
Marnel. What the?"
"But surely," George said, "he must have locked the barn."
"Stop calling me Shirley."
Half an hour later, the girls paid their checks.
They ate everything in half an hour? It's a lot.
The lady only mumbled.
"You're mumbling."
Dick and the girls hurried outside, jumped into Dick's car.
"I don't understand. Wait, what?"
"Oh." On a hunch, Nancy left the others to talk to the owner.
God, why did you skip over the word restaurant? Restaurant owner.
She held out both hands to...
Hounds? What?
The answer startled. "Look." He should never have made that threatening phone call to your home.